Are you ready to get naked for Scarface? I'm not, but I'm pretty psyched up about Madison right now. She's a pretty smart girl. She commits a few indiscretions, but I would totally invite her to the mansion if I were the half. She wants to talk first.
Could I have a drink? Just a little drink to break the ice.
No real hypno, please.
Let's get away. Come on. Do your thing.
This guy is so creepy.
I'm sorry. I think there's been a little misunderstanding. I'll just go. No harm done. Another time.
I think you misunderstood, honey. I'm tired of wasting my time. It's now or never. I never.
That's a good line. I should use that the next time I'm threatening to kill a girl if she doesn't have sex with me. Giving me an X like I'm not doing it properly. I guess I wasn't supposed to go in time with the music. I was just supposed to, like, slash it back and forth. Still need information from this guy.
Okay, act two. Let's hear Loverboy sing.
No one's gonna come in and check up on him, huh? Quick POV shot from Paco.
I'll kill you. Got it?
Shit. What you want?
You rent an apartment on Marble Street. I want to know why.
An apartment? I don't know what you're talking about. You haven't got the balls, lady. But you're going to know balls when I gush up with you.
You're gonna know balls when I catch up with you? It doesn't sound much like a threat.
Fucking bitch! I'm gonna kill you!
I chose busy and she starts moaning animalistically. This is a reprise of the Don Corneo scene from Final Fantasy VII.
What you doing? Stop it! Stop it!
I'm only getting started. How about some more?
I never set foot in that apartment. Gave the keys to some guy. He said he needed a place. He had money.
What was that guy's name?
John Shepard. Know his real name, not John Shepard.
Shepard! His name is John Shepard!
actually is going by John Shepherd.
There, that wasn't so hard, was it? I really appreciate this romantic moment, but I gotta dash. See you next time, lover boy.
So when he's setting up his sadistic scavenger hunts, he goes by his real name, which is John Shepherd. And probably in everyday life, he has a fake name, which is probably a name that we've already heard.
Time to get out of here.
But now Madison knows about John Shepherd.
I have a massive headache.
Conclusion. That's her conclusion? I thought she was going to give a conclusion about the crime. Not just like, you did really well, girl.
Nothing against techno, trance, whatever music, but this stuff is really loud. Well, that was a pretty good way of getting a guy to spill his guts.
Yeah, you almost eviscerated him.
Next time he'll think twice before he takes a cute chick up to his office.
Yeah, God forbid a man ever take a cute chick up to his office. It's the real problem. It's not like threatening to kill the girl or anything. It's just taking a cute chick up to your office. Doing that in and of itself is sexist. I didn't know Madison was such a feminist. I hope I don't fall out of love with her by the time this game is over, because right now I'm just like saving up some money to buy that diamond ring and working on my proposal line. Your polygons are ravishing. I feel ecstatic. I love it when you put on makeup and tear your skirt. Pride saved? Does that mean like I didn't get totally naked?
I'm here to see Paco. Paco? There ain't no Paco here, fella. Get lost.
I wish they'd shown up at the same time.
Are you absolutely certain? He's in his office. Take the stairs over there.
Stairs up to the office. I can't see where I'm going.
Look, I know you get me out of prison.
Are they back here? This looks like the entrance to the club. Paco's gonna be dead by the time I get up there. Yeah, Paco just had a little interview with John Shepherd. Or maybe it was the Shadow Monster. I couldn't quite make out the details. Oh, there's the stairs. Okay, I found the stairs. Objective A complete. Objective B is to speak to the dwarf who talks backwards. And then I'm gonna go behind the velvet curtains, and I'm gonna turn off the creepy music. Where I come from, the birds play a pretty song. Sing a pretty song. I come from the Federal Bureau of Investigation, biatch. He's got a giant punching bag. He's got a beautiful aquarium. Hey, fishy fishy. Would you like some algae? I'm gonna make a fishy face at the glass. I can't press my lips up to the glass and suck on it. He's got a samurai sword. What does this spell? Coward? Hard. He's got letters that spell hard on the floor, just in case his intentions with the young ladies he brings up here are not entirely clear. Well, time to search for clues. Fuck, it's the Shadow Man. The Shadow Man looks an awful lot like someone we know. Who are you? I passed every single one of those tests and he still escaped. Maybe those tests were just to stay alive, not to sleep with the fishies. Should be sleep with Paco and the fishies. You went upstairs? If you went upstairs, you better run after him. Anyway, the Shadow Man looked exactly like Scott Shelby. Did you see how husky he was and how large his coat size was? We saw the outline of that same coat on Lauren, and it was not a very great fit. But,
Paco know the guy who came to see him. Sorry.
That guy was definitely Scott Shelby. Scott should have thought of a better pseudonym than John, if that was his real name. He should have had like three names, a real name, an everyday life, you know, fake name, and then a criminal fake name, because skimping on the names is really not very wise. He definitely went up to the catwalks, too. Maybe he didn't go up to the catwalks, maybe the camera just decided to look at the catwalks for a moment. Okay, I do have to go back to the office and scan for clues. I've already figured this entire mystery out. I don't know what's up with these characters. I do have the benefit of being in all of the characters' heads at once, so that helps a little bit. What's on the floor here? There was a prompt. Oh, those are just my glasses. I have to pick them back up. I guess I got them. There's something else, though.
His coat pocket. We tore it off during the fight. Two receipts from the same gas station. Interesting.
Scott only buys his gas at Shell stations. Get it? He loves Shell. Ah, my humor is too sophisticated for this audience. I need to break out some dick and fart jokes. No, I don't want the glasses on yet. I want to look with my bare eyes at the rotting corpse of Scarface. No, I keep doing that. No glasses. What did he just do there? Oh, he put on the glove. It's a glasses and glove combination. I guess I can't look at Scarface. There's no prompt for that. Can I drink some whiskey? Some tequila? You know why the Mexican pushed his wife over a cliff, right? Tequila! Alright, that's a really bad joke. Tequila to kill her. I've got my gun, I've got my glasses. Do I have my trip though? Should I be searching the floor for blue vials? Oh look, there's my hard sign. I've been looking for that all day. I thought I left it in my coat pocket, which I took to the dry cleaners, but it was on the floor of this guy's club all along. Jaden's nickname is Hard when he's dealing drugs in the hood. Peddling that smack. He has nothing to say about the fish tank, huh?
Oh, got the shakes. I'm cold sweats.
He's got Tripto on his mind.
Get back to the hotel fast.
I guess he left his Tripto at the hotel. He doesn't want to have another Mad Jack incident. Oh, and there's something down here.
The killer was looking for something.
I don't even see the point of scanning for clues because, like, I have this mystery figured out. I don't really need Jaden to catch up with me.
Madison Page? What was the journalist doing here?
So she's a journalist in his database. She never actually told anyone she was a journalist.
Orchid pheromones. The fucking origami killer. Paco Mendez was no saint. His rap sheet reads like the telephone book.
That's a good line. Never heard that one before. And his dick is probably like a telephone pole. At least when Madison's dancing in front of him. He was born in Boston, Massachusetts to Carlo and Maria Mendez. 9854 something 3rd Street. I should actually knock on that door in real life and see if I can get any clues.
45 caliber.
Maybe they'll invite me in for some nice Mexican cooking. There is a clue on the corpse. You just have to use the glasses to find it.
A bullet. Instant death.
Yeah, the glasses could detect a bullet and he couldn't with his bare eyes. He might need to go back to training for a little while.
Madison Page? She may be a witness.
It's not too late for Jaden to meet up with Madison. There's still, what, like 20 whole minutes before Sean dies? Plenty of time. They could have like a jungle love scene for all I know. It was 3 hours a little while ago and a lot has happened since then. Let's get out of here. We know about Madison. That's all we need to know. I'm not going to say anything to this guy on my way out. I didn't really say anything to him on my way in, I just flashed my badge. It's nice to know that Paco paid extra for the light option on his railing. I wouldn't have respected him if he hadn't done that.
seem to spend most of my time in the shit. I don't know the basket case if you just keep going like this. That bastard nearly broke my neck.
Yeah, that bastard. What's his conclusion?
Shit. Looks like a dead end. That was a bummer.
Dead end, there's so many clues in this case. Open your eyes.
It all happens so fast. We have time to see his face. Gotta go.
You don't need to see his face, you just need to see his silhouette. I didn't have time to see his face. Well, I guess I'll just shoot up in an alley for the rest of my life. Nothing to see here. Hey, it's ladies' night at the Whiskey A Go-Go. Maybe I'll put on my fine red dress, go there. Ethan is so depressed right now. He just had to kill someone, even though the person shot at him first. He's a little shaky about the concept of self-defense. He doesn't really get that guns are there for defending you,
Ethan,
against bad people.
Are you alright?
Well, I guess the other guy could have been defending himself against Ethan, because Ethan pulled a gun on him and busted his way into his apartment.
I killed him. I had no choice. I had no choice.
I think the origami killer actually did choose a really, like, bad person to be the victim of Ethan during this trial.
You're not responsible for those murders. I can prove it.
That changes nothing. Saving Sean is all that matters now.
Oh my god, we have a romance scene coming up. It's been a long time in the making. Ethan had to kick this chick out of his room like 4 times before he could get this kiss, but acting like you're not interested, guys, if you're watching this, is the key to a lady's undies.